crossed paths with mortal imprudence. For now, we are safe. For now, my craving for blood remains. Red like hate, red like hunger, red as life and death passing from one immortal to another, from predator to victim, patiently biding its time to rise again. London has been cleansed for now, but there's a simmering hatred, fear, and old grudges. When will we succumb, mortals and immortals alike? The next disaster is only a matter of time. My only hope now is to catch the woman I love, to understand why she fled, and unmask the secret that has been lurking in her blood for so long.
Well, this is it. Lady Ashbury's domain. Why am I not surprised it's not on any maps? I'd better hurry.
Beautiful morn, my child. It looks like dawn is here at long last.
Can't you just leave me alone? Your precious queen has been sent back to the bottomless pit from whence she came. The nightmare is almost over.
I am here to say goodbye. The sun's warmth exhausts me. Soon I will rejoin my queen in her endless sleep. It is over. You did well.
So our beloved mother will just go back to sleep, now that enough people have suffered. Is that it?
No, Jonathan. The Morrigan has been appeased because you dared confront her. You have prevailed, my bittersweet champion.
Thank you. And what are you to her? Her counterpart? Her opponent in some timeless game?
She is my mother. My dreadful and sour-tempered mother. She is yours too, in a way, but you are not born from her terrible womb like me. You are but a distant child.
This is not over. I am here to find the true origin of the Blood of Hate.
'Tis unwise to interfere with a tale rooted so deeply in the suffering of others.
Thank you.
No. I must know why Elizabeth fled here when I discovered she was the original healthy carrier.
No, she is not what you say she is. That is a secret you will discover soon enough.
And you? Why are you here? Which new thread of which old twisted plan are you seeking to pull now? Tell me the truth.
I am just here to salute my sons. And to bid them fare thee well.
Your sons? Plural? My God, will you ever stop speaking in riddles?
Perhaps I am too old for your spoken language. Perhaps you now have so many subtle words you no longer hear the simplest ones.
Speak clearly, then.
What?
Did I defeat the...
Now you found the castle, Jonathan Reed.
It's locked, all right.
The Lady of the Manor isn't expecting visitors. Maybe it's just my imagination, but I think I smell Elizabeth's perfume. She must be here somewhere.
It's locked, all right.
This castle is falling apart. Like most castles, this one has a crypt. Hold something special inside.
It's locked.
Sweet fragrance. Elizabeth's perfume. She was here, and recently. What are these symbols? I can feel a mechanism, but it doesn't work.
Thank you.
This painting looks suspicious. A sword and a moon are the symbols I should look for. What are these symbols? I can feel a mechanism, but it doesn't work. Here's another switch. I should keep looking. One last switch, and... What are these symbols? I can feel a mechanism, but it doesn't work.
One last switch, and here's another switch. I should keep looking. One last switch, and symbols. I can feel a mechanism, but it doesn't work. One last switch.
Drop your sword, father. You have nothing to be afraid of.
Shall we abandon this then? Shall we lower our heads?
No. Never.
blood is approaching. Old but young. How strange. Shall I drink it? Smite it?
No, Father. He is a friend. Please, rest. I'll take care of it.
Caution, Elizabeth. Deceit runs through these veins.
I know, Father. What took you so long, Jonathan?
Is this really him?
Yes. This is William Marshall, 1st Earl of Pembroke, servant of 5 mortal kings, former regent and savior of England. The greatest knight who ever lived, according to some.
And you called him father?
For he gave me eternal life, and much more.
I have so many questions, Elizabeth.
You always had questions, Dr. Reed.
Now that I stand before you both, in this vault, I know not where to begin.
We still have a few minutes left.
Destroyed the disaster, this creature that Harriet Jones had become. The epidemic is no more, and London will recover. In time.
The city has suffered, but it will prevail in the end.
A more cynical analysis would be that this is an acceptable catastrophe.
I cannot bear knowing I was the cause of all this, through the use of my own blood.
No. This catastrophe was the result of unethical experimentation. And the will of a creature so inexplicably evil, she exceeds all the terrible wonders I have seen since my death.
But it was my blood all along. My corrupted blood of hate. The poisoned blood of my father. A healthy carrier. That's all I am.
William Marshall infected you. He is the true, original carrier.
Yes. But he saved me by sacrificing himself.
Saved you? How?
The tears of angels. The cleansing of impure blood by an older, more powerful blood. It worked on me, did it not?
Yes. Blood is the definitive key to our species. Scowls. Cleansing, lineage. Do you really think it worked?
It has, Jonathan. I was nothing but a beast who took pleasure in slaughter. I roamed across Europe, reaping my bloody crop. It was the blood of hate. But my father's antidote cured me.
What about us?
What do you mean?
You know my feelings towards you, Elizabeth.
I love you, Jonathan. I've loved you since...
You should have told me.
No, Jonathan. The William Marshall myth lies at the heart of so many hostile plans. I could not risk jeopardizing his safety.
So why did you come here? You knew I would follow you. I can't let you go.
Because I know now the blood of hate is still in my veins. No one but I can put an end to this tragedy.
I can help you. You can trust me, Elizabeth.
Do you remember Dorothy Crane? Aloysius Dawson? I love you, Jonathan Reed. I really do. But you cannot be trusted.
Would your protege agree to speak with me? I have so many questions for him.
Go on, Jonathan. But be careful.
Yes.
Sir William. My God. You really are William Marshall. You served Richard the Lionheart and his brother, King John. It is such a privilege to meet you.
I did in my day. Come closer if you want to speak. For my hearing isn't what it used to be.
I think your hearing is fine, sir.
What is it you want, then?
The blood of hate. How does it affect you? Do you feel it now?
The blood of hate? Yes. Nothing more than a sneeze, really. A sneeze held for so long, you could blow a fortress down if you released it.
Can we speak about them?
The Red Queen? What of her?
You met her, did you not?
Just once. But she never ceased to sing to me. I love her song. It is a song of blood and war. I only wish she would sometimes let me rest.
Do you know who she is?
I don't want to discuss this in front of my sweet Elizabeth.
Why?
For a time, she too could hear the Red Song. The steps she danced to its melody brought pain upon the world.
I would like to ask you about vampires.
Vampires? What about them?
Considering your experience, please tell me what you know.
They are terrible creatures. I have seen and fought many in my time. Foul temptresses with sharp claws and shrieking beaks.
Do you remember Murden, your maker?
Only God is my maker, for he created everything on this earth. He blessed me with eternal life through his archangel, Michael.
But Murden, Michael, is a vampire. He made you a blood-sucking creature of the night.
Blood, yes. I used to drink it from the throats of the unworthy. Then I was punished for my deceit. During my penance, I rely entirely upon my sweet Elizabeth.
Tell me about Elizabeth. How was she infected?
I do not wish to discuss it.
Please, Sir William. I need to know what the blood of hate is. How is it transmitted?
After defeating the disaster in St. Paul's Cathedral, I returned to my retreat, infected. This is where my sweet Elizabeth found me, for she heard my pain from across the sea.
Where is this retreat you mentioned?
In London, under Temple Church, beneath my empty tomb. I always loved to sleep there while listening to the bell above.
What happened then?
The blood of hate had twisted me into a rage-filled man. I attacked my progeny and infected her too. Forgive me, Elizabeth. I failed you.
You bit her again.
Is that how she was infected with the disaster's blood? I think I understand now.
Elizabeth fled, and I fell to my knees, begging for forgiveness. I swore I would find a way to make things right.
We could set you free, let you out. Isn't that what you want?
I pray for the day I'll see the sky again. I have all but forgotten its colors. I could walk and do so many things beneath the stars, but I doubt it would be wise to release me.
Then will you stay here and repent?
Elizabeth told me it will not be long now. I cannot wait to feel the sweet caress of her hand on my cheek after so long, as she releases me. Has the time come?
Yes, Father.
Why not unleash me then? To see the sky a final time?
You already are the sky.
Defeated, for I welcome the sword you bear, for it is mine.
You were never defeated, my lord. Farewell, Father. You also, Jonathan.
What do you mean?
I can't stand what I've become. This healthy carrier, as you put it. The flames will purify the poison that runs in my veins.
No! I won't allow this to happen.
I am death, Jonathan. Wherever I go.
We are vampires. We are death.
No, Jonathan. I won't bring another disaster into this world.
I can't lose you, Elizabeth. Even if it means putting the whole world at risk.
How can you say such an awful thing? Where is the Jonathan I once saved from a Skal in this abandoned factory?
I'm not that frightened man anymore. I've learned so much. Done so much.
I see. So there is nothing worth living for in this world anymore. Farewell, my love.
Farewell.
One prayer for the summoned, called by this song. Child born from darkness, whose path he must find. Now the song is sung and your path chosen. England is safe, the price paid most dear. But what do you care? You are the one who keeps killing. You've chosen your path, my fallen champion, like others before you. Prey to lust and desire, slave to the everlasting thirst. My queen sleeps once again, and I'll soon join her slumber. Until, alas, she rises, woken by the hunger never fed.